Recorded Books and RB Digital present Pop Magick, A Simple Guide to Bending Your Reality by Alex Kazemi. Foreword by Rose McGowan. Narrated by John Kroft. Foreword. A quote from Rose McGowan. Magick is the art of utilizing natural forces around us to bring about change. I stand for change. That's what this book does. It brings change. Change of thought, change of action, change of spirit. Magick is neutral, neither good nor evil. Take this book for what it is, a look behind and beyond the mirror. Come on the journey. Introduction. Welcome to a new magical age. The age of pop magick. If you are ready to learn how to bend yourself and bend reality through the practical applications of magick, then it's time for you to get weird and dive deep into the infinite other world. Pop magick is magick for us, the people. It's not something to be kept secret. Pop magick is for those who feel we are all magical beings, currently navigating the human experience. Deep down in our souls, we know there is more than what we have been taught by society, that the mystical forces around us are filled with purpose and possibility. Pop magick is for anyone who wants to engage those energies moving through the astral plane and collaborate with them in our own journeys through this temporal existence. Magick is not about adhering to dogma or defining yourself through aesthetics or binaries. It's about doing and practicing. It's about action. It's about performing ritual experiments and producing results. It's about recharging and expanding your freedom. It's about exploration and discovery. It's about knowing you have the power to change yourself and to change reality, to influence events by channeling the energies inside of you outward with intention. Practicing magick is all about your natural ability to access your will to bring order to chaos. The more results you produce, the more you will find yourself living a magical life. Magick becomes what you choose to make of it by inviting it into your life. When you open yourself up to magick, you are opening yourself up to the universe and its limitless potential to impact your life in ways that are substantive and positive. Magick is within your grasp, available to access right now. All it takes is your will and commitment. There is no right or wrong way to do magick, no good or bad way to practice it. You are the one who builds your bridge to the astral plane, establishing your own rules and guidelines along the way. The process of discovering your true self and divine will begins and ends with you. Magick is a means to improve yourself and your life, whether it's helping you survive the onslaught of the daily grind by bringing you peace and joy, or helping you achieve your goals by providing you with discipline and focus. Magick is a partner you can lean on to help you build the life you truly want to live. Are you ready to dip your toes into celestial pools? Do you want to feel a full moon lunar rush? It's time to access the inner treasure chest of tools and tap into the energies humming in the other worlds to bend reality and change your life. Chapter 1. Magick. I've never believed that you could simply wish upon a lucky star to get what you want. I believed you had to create the things that you want to see in the world yourself. People always ask me, why do you have so many of the things you want? How are you living your dream life? My answer is always the same. Magick. Magick is an inherent spiritual system that I didn't know I had within me. Maybe you don't realize this either. Hardly any of us do. We have to use our will to access it. Once we do, we are never the same again. Magick is how I live in a world where angels communicate with me through repeating numbers. I get to infect pop viruses into our culture, and my emotions are alchemized from reactive states into fuel used to propel me towards my goals. Magick is also how I can access a fountain of eternal peace within. Magick has taken me, a dude from the suburbs of Vancouver, Canada, everywhere from hanging out with the man who taught Oprah meditation, to Marilyn Manson tweeting about my art to some of the most secret behind-the-scenes parties in Hollywood. But the most important thing I've received is the VIP pass to the angelic space within that I needed to reach the divine will and the power to transform from an automatic, traumatized outsider addict boy into a connected, recovered young man. What you've heard is true. Magick has led to a collaboration with Selena Gomez and Petra Collins on a piece for Dazed, a conversation with Taylor Swift, a dinner in Beverly Hills with American Psycho author Bret Easton Ellis, becoming pen pals with Camille Paglia, and Madonna publicly expressing excitement on Instagram about an image that wouldn't exist had I not willed it into existence. In under 5 years of practicing magic, I have connected myself to some of the most iconic people our world has ever seen, and almost all of my living heroes. Now, I'm going to teach you how, with divine will, to access, remix, and take back your life from the magical energy suck world of today. Are you ready for pop magic, baby? In pop magic, magic has two definitions. 1. Magic is the science, art, and practice of bending reality in accordance with your true will. 2. Magic is the science, art, and practice of accessing your divine will to bring order to chaos. Magic is a technology to focus, direct, and communicate our will to the natural universe, to bend reality, affect changes, and produce results in the material world. The practice of magic is all about tapping into the unlimited resource of natural energy within yourself. You are the cause of your effect. It's about taking chances and trying different variables to produce either specific or abstract outcomes. It's about taking back your power and developing an awareness that you have the ability to direct your energy. You are sending your will to the unseen worlds by alchemizing it into energy. Something you must accept now, before you begin practicing this science, is that all of magic is theory. There is no evidence as to why it works. You, as the practitioner, will stitch together your own theories through your original data, i.e., your lived experience accumulated from your own practice and experience. Mystery is what makes practicing magic so powerful. Why dismiss something as fiction just because we don't understand it? Magic is not an act of the supernatural. Though it can sometimes seem nonsensical, and it operates on its own set of rules and logic, also known as total fucking chaos, it is of the natural world. No one can give you magical power. You have to do the work to earn it. Magic is not instantaneous, and there is no magic bullet method to materialize something into the physical world. All we can know is that through a practitioner's transmission, magic can cause change in the physical world. Some magical practitioners believe that almost anything you do with will or intention is a magical act. Something as simple as buying a Pepsi from 7-Eleven by classic occult definitions can be a magical act. You set your intention and will and achieved a result. Magical practitioners who receive results always think of things that can happen in the material world. There are no limits to the beliefs, but there is logic. Asking to grow angel wings or to wake up with six-pack abs is science fiction. However, you can perform a spell to seek the discipline to go to the gym and then create momentum in the material world that could result in the achievement of a muscular stomach. No one knows how magic works. We simply know that it does. I'm sure most of us can't explain how a phone charger cord works to charge our iPhones, but we still do it every day. Sometimes you don't need to know how something works. When we practice magic, we plug into the unknown energies that are zipping and zapping around us. Magic does not require belief to work, but I do think believing in magic and having a will to discover it through your concrete sense of knowing is how you can discover it in all areas of your life, including your practice. Even if you choose not to believe in its existence, magic is always happening because practitioners are experiencing results. You, the practitioner, are the one who gets to define whether magic is something that you do or if magic is something you were born to be. Remember, there is no such thing as coincidence, only magic. Chapter 2. Magical Ritual. Have you ever prayed? If so, you have participated in a magical ritual. You have successfully interacted, bridged, and acknowledged the unseen dimensions, whether you refer to this union as the astral plane, the spirit world, or the kingdom of heaven. You have requested the materialization of something to be sent to you from beyond this physical world. The only difference between a prayer and a ritual is that prayer relies on surrender, and magic requires you to tap into the energy within to create the outcome you seek. A magical ritual uses the combination of props, timing, visualization, and directing your will to release the energy to create a change in the material world. In the context of witchcraft, a magical ritual is a spell. A spell is simply directing your energy to a prop with the intention of producing an outcome. All of us witches, sorcerers, and magical practitioners are playing with the same unknown forces right under the same blue skies as our ancestors. We don't give a fuck that we cannot successfully comprehend or understand magic. We just know that it exists and works. You must take responsibility when making the decision to bring order to any chaos that is caused by a magical ritual. It is your energy being sent out, after all. Go into ritual work with curiosity, openness, and a belief in all possibilities. Don't let your prejudices or preconceptions keep you stuck in a lower version of reality. The ingredients used in the performance of a pop magic ritual: intention plus desire plus will. How do you decide on your intention? It's simple. Ask yourself what you want. What is the reason you are doing this spell? What is the outcome you desire? If you could light a candle and by the end of it affect nature's order to bring something about, what would it be? Do you even know why you want it? When you identify your will, you are allowing your conscious self to take charge of your subconscious self. Try to challenge your own will. What do you dream of experiencing? And what do you believe you are capable of? Challenge yourself by asking, is this coming from the pools of my soul, the essence of my true self? Timing. In pop magic, the moon is our clock. We tune ourselves to be conscious of nature's rhythms to create the most effective results in our practice. During the light of the moon, the 2 weeks following the new moon, when the moon is waxing, we perform rituals to draw things into our lives. During the dark of the moon, the 2 weeks after the full moon, when the moon is waning, we perform rituals to alchemize what no longer serves us. On the full moon, we are at our most powerful, and so is our magic. Any type of ritual is more likely to succeed when done under a full moon. On the new moon, we perform rituals revolving around new beginnings and spiritual rebirth after surviving the trials of the waning moon. Props. In pop magic, There is no paraphernalia or prop that has inherent magical power. You can use anything in a ritual. You are the power. Candles, sigils, poppets, and ribbons, common essential ritual ingredients, are not inherently powerful. But when you bring them into ritual and charge them with your energy, they become powerful tools and factors in achieving results. Some practitioners swear by using green candles for success spells, but what if you want to use a red one? Gasp! What if you achieve a result for a success spell using a red one? Do what you want by trusting your soul's compass. There are no right or wrong rules. I swear the only reason I met Taylor Swift was because I did spells at my friend's house using tap water from his kitchen sink. Was the tap water magical? Nah. Sometimes there are magical emergencies. One time, I stopped and did a spell with a tree on a sidewalk in the middle of the day for my phone's keyboard. I use a burner phone to get fixed. It worked. Thanks, sidewalk tree. Raising the energy. Raising the energy is your magical pre-game. It's like getting yourself as psyched up as possible before you're going somewhere. But in this case, you are going to your ritual. Do whatever gets you in the mood for a big night out or a celebration. You want to put your energy on full blast and blow out the speakers. It is advised to raise the energy before every magical ritual. Emotion is your aid. You want to achieve a level of potency, increasing your vibe to the highest degree possible, to the point where your whole body is buzzing. This will increase the likelihood of achieving a result. Your highly charged feelings and thoughts of why you feel so strongly about what it is you want to will amp you up to direct and release the energy of your will. Sometimes I want something so badly I don't need to raise the vibe because I'm in such a highly charged emotional state, and I am desperate to release the excitement over what I want. On a full moon, though, I religiously dance to Hands to Myself by Selena Gomez. I bang my body in the air, spin in circles, and close my eyes. I totally lose myself and enter a trance state. Do whatever builds the power up in your body. Do anything that builds emotion for you. Try to chant while you dance so you can feel the buildup of energy. In pop magic, this is how we alter our state of consciousness, by dancing to pop music under full moons. Crazy, right? You can use dancing, trance, any type of music, colors, and symbols to alter your state. Anything that compels you to feel magical and to enter a zero-mind state. I don't condone staying up for days, using drugs as a means of a portal to access powerful entities, or forcing yourself into dangerous situations to alter your state of consciousness. Some magical practitioners swear by these experiments to open up the gates to other worlds. If that's the way you roll, go for it, and tell me how it works out for you. I've been getting prime results with my Gomez Gate to the Other Worlds regime. Visualization. This either might disappoint you or make you super stoked. But the same kind of visualization that Oprah talks about is the exact same technique that witches, occultists, and magical practitioners have always used to cast out and charge the energy for a specific outcome via ritual or spells. Cue cultural appropriation occult versus New Age debate here. At this very moment, can you picture in your mind the last website you visited? The outside of the last shop you went into? Your favorite pair of shoes? Your favorite Disney character? This is visualization, the conscious decision to see with your mind as opposed to your eyes. In a magical ritual, we create in our mind images that do not yet exist. Visualization is conscious, lucid dreaming. Holding a will to activate that place where it all feels so real. You are catapulting something, setting magic into motion, sending out and releasing your energies to bring forth something into our material world. The only difference in pop magic is we are conscious of the variables and factors. We believe in the moon's influence on our energy and will. We are scientists of this technique who are constantly testing out different ways to achieve results. It all comes back to this. Magical practitioners don't believe in thinking positive and doing nothing. Pop magic is about creating results in the real world. Direction plus release of the energy. 1. Close your eyes and imagine what it would be like to have what it is that you want. Imagine the feeling it would give you right now. 2. See yourself as if you were there, inside of the end result you are putting your will towards. Think of the sounds you would hear, what you would see, and what it would look like. Do everything you can to paint the most graphic visual in your mind of what it would be like to have what it is that you want. Imagine the exact feeling of experiencing the end result as if it is happening right now. 3. Feel the energy beaming from your body. Feel all the euphoria casting out of you. Think of putting all of yourself and all of your will directed at this exact result. Think of how this desire is coming from the highest, most authentic streams of your soul. Try to think of how at some point you wanted something so badly you literally felt like you would die if you didn't have it. Experience those graphic feelings of passion, desire, and the will to get it. Involve and immerse yourself in this need and validate that this need is real for you. Now, direct that passion, desire, and will towards that end result bursting in your mind. When you feel you can no longer hold the energy inside, release it. Let it all out. The magic begins once you expel the energy. You will know when you are ready to release. When you feel you cannot hold the energy anymore, release the energy. The magic has begun. 4. Forget about the magic. Forget about the results. Let it go and let it work. Chapter 3. How to materialize magical energy. Rub your palms together for 22 seconds. Start slow, but then rub faster and faster. Feel your muscles tense up. Let your palms grow hot. Stop and hold your palms about 3 inches apart from each other. Can you feel them tingle? This is a materialization of magical energy. When you rub your palms together and use the rest of your body to raise the energy, that is generating magical energy. Start to recognize this energy as the same type of feelings that arise from our body when we are horny, terrified, angry, nervous, or euphoric. In pop magic, emotion equals energy. Energy can be molded like a metaphysical snowball. You hold the ability to alchemize and release the magical energy from within you. Raise, control, and direct. Chapter 4. Specific outcome and abstract outcome magic. In pop magic, there are two types of magic. 1. SOM, specific outcome magic, is the intention to materialize a specific outcome into the material world. 2. AOM, abstract outcome magic, is the intention to materialize an abstract outcome into the material world. Specific outcome magic is when we cast out our energies to create a specific outcome in our reality. A specific outcome can be anything. The exact job you want, the exact romantic partner you want, the exact sexual partner you want, the exact text message you want to receive. This is the most common form of magic, and the reason most magical practitioners perform rituals. In my earlier magical days, I did SOM almost every day. I couldn't stop once I realized that the more I practiced SOM rituals, the more things I wanted actually happened. I have received life-changing results practicing SOM, but I have also received devastating results. I have gotten the things I wanted and then felt empty, ashamed, and depressed after because of the amount of chaos I caused and the people who got hurt in the long run. I have hurt myself a lot doing SOM. I had fallen far past being seduced by the illusion of the material world. I am not reducing SOM to selfish or narcissistic behaviors, but I will say it's easy to become greedy. You might learn at some point on your path that surrendering to the natural order of events, allowing life to happen, and handing over your trust to the spirit guides can create beautiful, specific outcomes. You might switch between SOM or AOM. I would be lying if I didn't credit SOM to an acceleration in my career success. I would be lying if I said SOM wasn't the reason you are holding this book in your hands. What I learned practicing SOM is that the material things I accrued through ritual were never going to make me happy. And the good things I received through ritual that were spiritually nourishing likely would have happened anyway. A lot of magical practitioners are fully dedicated to the belief that nothing can be manifested unless you manifest it on the astral plane first. But I challenge that belief by my lived experience. I have attained things I've wanted and needed without doing SOM. What I have learned from practicing magic is that the events that need to happen in your life will happen. Abstract outcome magic is when you cast out your energies to bring something into your life without having a specific outcome in mind. An abstract outcome could be asking for more joy or asking for a job opportunity that will make you happy, even though you have no idea what that job might be. AOM is about not knowing how to get something, but believing it is possible to receive it without knowing the practical plan to achieve it. You are trusting the universe to send you trials and symbols to bend reality. AOM is similar to prayer or sending out a wish without a specific clarity, something that is a charm and won't harm anyone. You can go as far as using universal energy instead of your own, and just trying to be a vessel to send out the higher energies to influence a positive outcome. AOM could be viewed as clean or cautious magic. From my own experience, when I have done AOM, there has been little to no chaos when the results manifest. It seems harmonious, events aligning to a point of perfection. It feels like a dream, something that was always meant to happen. I feel AOM is happening on those flow days where things just feel good and right. AOM is the kind of magic that happens in life when you don't expect it and didn't think you would receive it. Chapter 5. Where to Apply Magic. Are you ready to obtain that job you've always wanted? Do you want to love yourself in ways you never believed possible? Do you want to be more driven and disciplined, achieving the goals you fantasize about? There are rituals for each of these things and more. Magic can be employed in all areas of your life to create opportunities. I have used magic to collaborate with my icons, to help people, and to completely restructure my way of being. I've become friends with people who I seem to have known in a past life because of our spiritual connection. I've extracted myself from complicated demonic trials. I've alchemized destructive states into willpower. I've used magic to positively influence the lives of others, with their permission, of course. Magic is something I use every day and can do it anywhere. Prior to practicing magic, I didn't know how to utilize the energy of desire and will. I would let it completely take me over. But now I can alchemize and redirect that passion towards ritual, while taking practical steps toward realizing my goal. I may have done rituals on multiple moon phases to materialize the book you are holding, but it didn't arrive out of thin air. It still required a dedicated work ethic and divine will. The combination of hard work and the power of nature is how I achieve successful results in my daily life. Areas in which to apply magic: self-love, self-improvement, career, purpose, alchemy, protection, sex, love, romance, helping others, and anything else you can think of that is of the natural world. Remember, there are no specific or correct correspondences when doing a ritual. It's all about what feels right for you as the practitioner and what you associate with the area of your life you are deciding to work on. I can do a self-love spell with a rock I find on the ground, and it could be just as effective as using a pink candle that corresponds with Libra. There are no rules, only magic. Before doing a ritual, ask yourself, what do I want? See if it feels right, whether it's coming from your soul. Try to understand why you desire the result that you want before doing the magic. Your intention should be meaningful and genuine.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.